let's go over to the US. Now, we hear all the time about misinformation and disinformation, and, you know, of course, here in Australia, we've got this misinformation, disinformation bill coming up. You had the President's Press Secretary, Corinne Jean-Pierre, most recently trying to claim that videos of Joe Biden were deep fakes and cheap fakes, and that they were misinformation and disinformation, that were lying to you about the real state of the president. Well, we all saw him at the debate on Friday. I think we can all agree they were not cheap fakes or deep fakes. But this is the line now, misinformation and disinformation. It's what politicians use when they want to discredit someone's argument, i.e. facts that they don't like, that go against their argument. Well, funnily enough, Kamala Harris, the Vice President of the United States, has been caught out engaging in misinformation and disinformation herself. She tweeted this: Donald Trump would ban abortion nationwide. President Joe Biden and I will do everything in our power to stop him and restore women's reproductive freedom. Let me repeat that. Donald Trump would ban abortion nationwide. Well, isn't it good that these days we have things like, I don't know, videos, and I'm not talking about cheap fakes or deep fakes, that we can go back to that prove these kind of statements wrong? Roll the tape.
My view is now that we have abortion where everybody wanted it from a legal standpoint, the states will determine by vote or legislation or perhaps both, and whatever they decide must be the law of the land, in this case, the law of the state. Many states will be different.
So that was April. Donald Trump saying that the states will make their own laws. And now Kamala Harris claims that he will institute a national ban on abortion. It's simply not true. Now, of course, one of the interesting things about the fact that she put it on X, formerly Twitter, Elon Musk's platform, is that these days when someone puts misinformation or disinformation on X, you can actually go on and make a complaint, and they put a little addendum at the bottom of the tweet or the post or whatever it's called now that points out the actual truth. And Elon Musk himself harnessed this today. He said, when will politicians, or at least the intern who runs their account, which in most cases is probably true, if you check Joe Biden's Twitter account, my God, some of the stuff that's posted on there is just inane. And learn that lying, when will they learn that lying on this platform does not work anymore? I mean, it's just a bald-faced lie. On what basis would she try to claim that there is going to be a nationwide ban on abortion? He's literally never said it.
Because they're shilling for votes, and right now they are desperate for votes, especially after Friday's performance from the sitting president, or should I say lack thereof, performance. But yeah, they're desperate, and they know that nothing harnesses, especially the female fury of the US. We saw this when Roe v. Wade was overturned by the Supreme Court. I mean, you've just not seen scenes like that for a very long time. This gets people on both sides, whether you're pro or anti, absolutely rabid. And she is trying, by lying, to make women believe that nationwide there's just going to be a complete kibosh on abortions. It is a lie, but she's doing it in order, I guess, appealing to the lowest common denominator, who doesn't know well enough. The community note that X then slapped on her tweet literally said, I quote, President Trump has repeatedly said he will not sign a national abortion ban, and had five links attached, so that if people were questioning the community note, they could click on any number of those five links and watch him say it